This is Atlas Launch Control, and after a successful launch today and the successful deploy of the TDRS-M satellite, we are very pleased to be joined by our NASA launch manager from NASA's Launch Services Program here at Kennedy Space Center, Tim Dunn.
Thank you, Mike. Great to be here.
It was a beautiful launch and a great mission. We had a little bit of a delay earlier on, and I wondered if you could just give us an overview of what that was all about.
Oh, sure. Be glad to. So obviously, there's a lot of relief on the team right now, a lot of celebration, a lot of excitement. Love spacecraft separation. It's the best part of a launch campaign. So many hours are put into getting to this exact point when you know you have a healthy satellite that you've just separated from the launch vehicle about to go do its mission that it was intended for. So we were had a beautiful morning, great weather, great rocket prop loading with cryos, no problems there, power on sequence went really well. And as we were chilling the Centaur engine down, we noticed one of the chill down parameters on the thermal conditioning for the LOX side was not quite getting cold enough in time to meet the original 8:03 a.m. T0. So we need a little extra time. So you heard a little bit of discussion on the net. What we wanted to do was maximize our opportunity and try to preserve as much of our 40-minute window as possible. So you heard us kind of stepping through from a 8:03 to about an 8:15, 8:16, 8:18, and then we knew it was probably out around the 8:30 time frame. So that's what you heard as we were marching through that, because should we not have launched on that opportunity, we wanted to leave ourselves 10 or 15 minutes on the backside to get another potential recycle. So appreciate everyone's patience. I know those, when you're not part of the team that's working the anomaly, and you don't look at the data, it gets a little bit frustrating, and you're not sure, wait, when are these guys going to launch today? Are they not? We don't know. But ULA did a magnificent job of managing the situation, diligently mapping out and extrapolating the data to give us that opportunity and let us all target in on that 8:29 opportunity.
There was a lot of conversation going on nets behind the scenes.
Absolutely.
With you and Bill Cullen, the United Launch Alliance launch director, and Ed Kidda, the launch conductor, and
yes,
the teams,
yep,
along with the TDRS-M spacecraft team, in working your way through that,
yes,
and coordinating a new T0 time.
Yes, you may have heard my discussions with the spacecraft side, because TDRS-M was rock solid in the payload fairing, ready to launch at any point during our 40-minute window. But I need to give the spacecraft mission director a heads up so that he can prepare the downrange assets to know when the new T0 is. So you heard a lot of that discussion, but I'll just take a moment to extend your comments about the team, that you may just hear guys like a launch director, an NLM talking, but there are thousands of people that we represent, from ULA, to NASA Goddard, NASA KSE, NASA headquarters, and then Boeing, who built the spacecraft. They've got a wonderful team that built this satellite and got it ready for today, and it's going to operate on orbit for what we hope is 10 or 15 years. So a great day for the team. It's always a great day when you launch, and we're going to really celebrate this one. And one thing, Mike, I've got for you here is, you know, I love the NASA meatball as much as any other person in our agency, but I also brought you something here.
Thank you
the
very
TDRS-M
much.
The TDRS-M pin. And I got a second one, because I was watching you and Josh. You guys, I want you to put these on.
All right.
You're part of our team.
We will do that, Tim. Thank you so much. And thank
all
you
right
once again on a very successful launch today at 8:29 a.m. Eastern Time. It was a beautiful day, and congratulations. Great job managing the team.
Thank you.